and we can understand very well. They are peace, justice, and the environment. Peace, justice, and the environment. All three are interconnected, all three are high priorities. One reason why the environmental emphasis is picked up now by the Western countries is because it will at least mute the extreme demand for justice. All the Western countries are now prepared to put money into the environment, but they are not prepared to put money into justice. Or easy. It's also become old fashioned after the socialist countries have collapsed. These economic systems are already here. This is not the case because the world remains just as badly armed, as badly insecure as before. But peace has now been eclipsed. Justice has to be eclipsed. Otherwise, the establishment cannot live. The crime of the victims of injustice is so strong. One way of using that cry is to pick up some issues which are legitimate and highlight them in such a way that this justice issue will be addressed. I just tell you my views which are not very popular. Three of these views are human rights, women's rights particularly, with all legitimate concerns. Human rights is a legitimate concern, feminism, men's rights is a legitimate concern, so is the environment. But why are these three being pushed in order to mute the demands of justice? This is the background in which I have seen this whole problem. I was at Rio at the environment conference. I have been involved in environmental issues since 1968, at that time, that actually was happy that Shimpanari got on to the issue. He had already got on to the other parent, long before our people. Only recently, this has now been pushed. It has been pushed with a particular intention. Of course, the environmental problem is very large and very big. It's pushed by interesting. So we have to keep that in mind when we jump into the environment bandwagon. Everybody in the West is going the environment way. We should be careful about not being taken in. I'm going to say that in discussing the environment issue, there is more than lifestyle involved. Oh, lifestyle is very important. The first thing for me is all these three problems, war, injustice, and destruction of the environment, comes from the urban technological industrial civilization, which is a special product of the European culture, which is now spreading everywhere. And the environmental problem, in order to be solved, must look at the whole complex. Urban technological industrial civilization and its among goals. Of course, what Professor Iti said is true, that human acquisitiveness, human need, human desire for immediate gratification is one of the instruments used to promote the ideology of human development. We have seen that you can appeal to your desire for comfort, desire for pleasure, desire for power, then you can sell them many more things. To fit inside the desire for these things, before you can sell them, the commodities you can sell. That is how the system functions. Now just say just simple things about this environmental issue. First of all, the environmental issue, we are concerned about all of existence, not just life. All all living beings, not just human beings, but also animals, plants, trees, wood, bacteria, fish, algae, all the things are involved in the environmental problem. But now human living beings need environmental protection, mostly from human beings. They can more or less resist ecological catastrophes, but they cannot resist what human beings are doing. Human beings are poisoning the soil, poisoning the water, poisoning the air. Even poor non-human living beings are suffering from our actions. That is the heart of the problem of the human mind. But the second thing that I want to say is that the wrongdoing is that the life should not be abstracted from contact. Life cannot exist without contact. What should we call contact? How can we live without the sun, the moon, the air? We cannot live. Rivers, not life. So the environmental concern is not just for life, but all the factors which support it, which includes non-living beings and animals. That I think we should not forget. The ecosystem is a symbiotic reality. It is living, depending on each other. And non-life and life are one package. You cannot separate life from non-life in this world, because all life that we know is heavily dependent on non-life. I cannot live for 1 second if air is not, or if the sun doesn't. So, let's not make a false separation between the protection of life and our attention to the belong together in one sphere of effects. Matter is part of existence. Next thing I want to say is something which is more difficult to define. I believe that there are two major sets of issues in the environment of existence. Only one set is getting attention now. The other set is being neglected. Mostly because of the lack of confidence. Let me say what is asking. The first, and I think, what is there and who am I in the midst of all that is there? That question is fundamental to the environment, because the Western problem is that they separate the subject and the object. They did not see that the subject was a part of that world which was trying to develop. They somehow thought of the subject as a developer and the object as a world. This kind of thinking is fundamentally wrong. And this conceptual issue of moving the human being in relation to the reality of the individuals, not over against us, not something for it to objectify, study through science, and manipulate through technology. That conception is at the bottom of the environment. So unless there is a fundamental change in our understanding of what a human being is in relation to the rest of reality, and overcome the subject-object dichotomy in which human beings think that they are the masters of the universe, that they can manipulate and control it as they wish, that they are not different from it. That is what freedom in the Western process of the 19th century means, not being dependent on anything. That is different, because human beings are dependent, heavily dependent on animals, plants, trees, non-life, everything. What we want to be? Non-dependent. We think if we know how to things work, and if we can manipulate, get the technology to make them work according to our principles, then we will be independent. Science and technology will give us autonomy and independence. The others will no longer be a threat because we know what keeps them together. It is this perception which is behind this civilization itself that is responsible for the environment. In that aspect, that is being neglected. Even in Rio, it is very difficult to make a change. And to get to the youth to say, yes, there is something there, but I don't know how to go. What people say, I can't deal with it. That's what they should like to deal with. I don't deal with it. So that issue is not taken on. The other is working related to problems of finding both ecological balance and remedies and solutions for the problems. But the solution of the problems will be faulty if we accept our blame for this problem. That is what I want to say. Basic understanding of reality is where the fault claims of humanity that can be examined. When you examine that, you will also see that the present civilization itself is based on the wrong concept of reality. And so that civilization will have to change if this ecological problem is to be and first, I have already said, this false separation of the subject and knowledge. In the West, the great quest was for a non-subjective objectivity. The whole of the quest of knowledge, the prophet times and the superior times, is to find a knowledge system which is objective. It is nothing more. The subjective is where all the mistakes come in. The object doesn't make any mistakes. Only the subject can make mistakes. So if you want to eliminate mistakes, you must eliminate subjective. But what they did not realize was that subjectivity is the essential aspect of all perception. And without subjectivity, there will not be objects. If there is no subjectivity, of the objects. This is a fundamental mistake. The idea that the human being can stand outside reality, study it, and manipulate it. Instead of understanding that the human being is an essential, integral element of reality, and is shaped by it. That point of view of separating the subject from the object and the idealizing of objectivity as truth has been one of our big problems. That's a civilizational problem. Comparing biology and physics, we know that we cannot separate the subject from that which is perceived. The measuring instrument and the measure are part of the reality that we measure. We know that now it's micro level, but it's also true in the macro level. There's no way I can stand outside the world and look at the world objectively. And part of the process which is called the world. Okay. Ready? Are we stable? Are we science? The technology based on are based on this kind of subject and object identification. They now realize it. It's very difficult. Scientists themselves to see that the whole project of science is based on the wrong understanding of knowledge. The next point I'm going to say on that is that reality is one in which there are differences, but also both are there. Not everything is the same, but there is something which cannot be said. differences are not final, the unity is not without the difference. But that aspect we must keep in mind, that Krishna is for me inorganic matter, organic or biological being, and human consciousness are simply three aspects of the same end. Each one is different from the others. Consciousness that stands out there by itself. Consciousness is something which now has a physical being. Forget the concept of unity, which unites the level of non-organic, organic, and consciousness. Okay. Now, I don't want to give you this idea of this size down there. Views about this part are inconsistent with all inclusive. That the Western Republic, which has had a few of Sankhya, which is our basic system in India, in which there is dualism, but still the aham is seen as a part of reality and not as something that stands outside that won't bother you with. Let me briefly say something about the second aspect of which all of you are experts. I will only enumerate some of the problems which I have seen. First thing is over the question of absolute. And the constituent increase in the level of atmosphere, with potentially disastrous psychological consequences. Exhaustion of non renewable energy sources. Failure to do sufficient intelligent research and development of making renewable alternative sources of energy available. That is the first problem that I see. Also, human values in the use, we must replace them by renewable energy. That's one. That is a good idea. I'm not going to just produce a story, but just produce problems like this. The problem of CFC, consumption of chloroform atoms, and therefore, depletion of the absorption of fire, the absorption which affects us from harmful vegetations. It's a second important problem of the subject. In Africa, already there is high incidence of cancer because of the absorption of vegetation. And radiation-related diseases are also deep. Of course, let's do it. We are aware of this, but the nature of this is together. Think about the government, you can think about reducing the production of CFC, but you know, the government has to think about it. They say it is the new year is to be differently, but I have not so much. Okay, see, the excessive use of chemical fertilizers and pesticides in agriculture leads to the toxification and leaching of the soil to accumulate high plastic fragments in human and other biosystems. So, I think there to be the solution is rather obvious. Let me give you my favorite idea that through managing and through agriculture, we have overloaded the air and as well as our bodies. There must be a detoxification of soil and in the human body. Which is possible only on large-scale manufacturing, organic fertilizer. And there are new techniques involved for making organic
animal is
saturated, they are more productive than
the habitual
factor.
Bangalore,
Jagadu
looks down,
especially Bangalore,
organic
animal
generating
system,
it is very
effective.
They say that
it is much better than
chemical
fertilizers
in terms of
crop
productivity
and
even
taste
of foods
and taste
of vegetables
produced
like that
is
much better.
So,
decalcification,
decalcification,
both
aspects of
organic
medicine,
and
then in
other
sources
of huge
toxification,
lots
of chemicals
being
harmful.
Okay,
the
next point
I want to speak
to you about
is
soil
erosion.
Consensus
professional
laws
developed is resistant traits of bacteria exactly the same effect as AIDS. What's the difference between AIDS and this? AIDS means you have no resistance. And this means also you have no resistance. It's just as bad. But AIDS is something which is now well known. The other question is not known. I think we have to do something about this. Bacteria as an antibiotic culture must be questioned. Okay, then the other thing is indiscriminate use of the finite resources of our earth, which may result in very big catastrophes for future generations, for us also, but much more for future generations. We are making the world uninhabitable for future generations. In environment, we have to have a special responsibility for future generations, because it's not simply the problem of the humans in our lifetime, future is also very important. Okay, at the Rio summit where I was present, some consciousness of second set of issues was reached. But we discovered a number of problems. One, the industrial system would like to farm off the responsibility for protecting the environment on the general public. They will not take responsibility for that. They will not shell out the money to change the environment. That became very obvious in the end. That's very one of our biggest problems in which we haven't yet faced this. Even in this country, the big corporations have to spend a lot of their knowledge on remedying the environment, and we must struggle for it. We must not simply look to the government to put the bill for all this environment. Those who are benefiting from the industrial system must also bear an important part of the cost. All come back to us, the poor consumer, because whatever they spend, they will take from us. Government also is taking our money and putting it into it. The way the one who finally pays personal is good. But still, I think we must assist the corporations to do this. One of the problems is which I have to say, one boy and another is strong. You see, we are now in a world where the major tax issue in the allocation of economic power, the state is becoming a secondary power. Primary power is the economic production units. Over there, the power is in that and all our world trade agreement and world trade organization, guard, post guard, everything, that is all about the transnational corporations. They are setting down their will as the source for law. The state simply has to do it because the state is only a secondary economic power, very highly dependent on the natural economic power. And so they are the ruling elements in the world. And what is the best strategy for you? I used to be violent anti-transnational. But I find that it doesn't work. But 20 years ago, we pointed that all the big transnationals in Europe who have worked in South Africa, we talked to them about what they are doing in South Africa. We were not about that. And we also did that. But we had several people. After that, Zimbabwe, this world, which if you know, I remember, there, stood up and said, I heard what the preacher is saying. And then he said to us, you don't have to teach us the gospel. I know it. I'm the son of the mission. That's how I said to this. I'll tell you what the gospel is in case you don't know the preachers. The gospel is only two things. Man is a sinner. God forgives. That's the Thank you very much.